السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. الشهور 12 كمثل أولاد يعقوب عليه وعليهم السلام، وشهر رمضان بين الشهور كيوسف بين إخوته، فكأن يوسف أحب الأولاد إلى يعقوب، فكذلك شهر رمضان أحب الشهور إلى علام الغيوب. One of the things, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, that Ibn al-Qayyim says is that there are, of course, 12 months. الشهور 12, like the 12 sons of Yaqub alayhi salam. And the example of Ramadan with regards the other months is like the example of Yusuf with regards the other 11 brothers. And just like Yusuf is the most beloved son to Yaqub alayhi salam, then Ramadan is the most beloved month to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The month that is impending, my dear brothers, is just about around the corner, we're about to approach, is the month of all months. It's the king of all months. It's the month Ibn al-Jawzi describes here, kataj ala ra's al-zaman. It's the crown of all months. It's the greatest of months. But we, of course, are in the month of Sha'ban. فَمَضَى رَجَبْ وَمَا أَحْسَنْتَ فِيهِ فَيَا مَنْ ضَيْلَوْ قَاتُ جَهْلًا بِحُرْمَتِهَا إِفْقٌ وَحْذَرْ بَوَارَقْ. We are in the month of Sha'ban and Rajab has passed. So, oh, the one who wasted his time in Rajab by not knowing of the fada'il, of the value of that month, here is your chance to wake up in the month of Sha'ban before the month of Ramadan. My dear brothers, just like Yusuf alayhi salam was a prophet of patience, was a prophet from whom we understand for sabrun jameel, and patience is jameel, it's beautiful. Just like Yusuf alayhi salam is the example for everyone who is in prison, for every family who is touched by imprisonment, then Yusuf alayhi salam is your example. Yusuf alayhi salam is your imprisoned prophet. Then Yaqub alayhi salam is your prophet of mourning, is your prophet who misses. إِنَّمَا أَشْكُوا بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. Indeed, my grief and my anguish is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise, Ayyub alayhi salam is your example of illness, is your example of a prophet who was sick, of your example of a prophet who was ill. وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبُّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And the example of Ayyub alayhi salam in the Quran, when he was touched by a calamity and he said, oh Allah, I've been struck by a disaster, by a calamity, and you are still the most merciful of the most merciful. And Allah says in another place, فَاسْتَجَبْنَاهُ فَكَشَفْنَا مِنْ ضُرٍ. Allah says, Allah responded and replied to him and removed his illness. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنْ أَهْلِهِ. And Allah returned him a family. وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعُهُمْ. And on top of that, more offspring. Why? For what? And how? رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدَنَا. A mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذِكْرَى لِلْعَابِدِينَ. And a reminder for those who worship. Not for everyone, my dear brothers. Not for everyone, not a reminder for everyone, but a reminder for those who worship. Because only those who worship can truly understand that a Muslim, a mu'min, is two halves that come together in one person. What are they? Like Ibn al-Qayyim said, as-sabr wa shukr, nisful iman. This is our two halves that come together in a person, and they are patience and gratitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, I didn't know, in fact, that hugs were set up by women. I didn't know that. And when I was watching the presentation and I saw this was set up by women, and I should have done my own research. But in any case, I thought about this. Think about this, my dear brothers. Think about the sa'i that you make when you go to visit Allah's house in Umrah or Hajj. The sa'i that you make. What do? You walk and you run and you climb. In memory of who? In recognition of who? A woman. Hajar alayhi salam was a woman who had her son Ismail alayhi salam, who she left in the middle. What did she do? She walked and she ran and she climbed and she went back down and she walked and she ran and she climbed And she went back down and she did that 7 times. Why? In search of what? In search of water. For who? For her son. That is a sa'i. That is the effort of a woman. And what does Allah say in the Quran? وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى وَأَنَّ سَعْيَهُ سَوْفَ يُرَى. Man will only have what he made sa'i for. You will only achieve and get established what you traversed, what you made effort for. And Allah says, and everyone will see the fruits of his labor, of his effort. وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاعِمَةٌ لِسَعْيِهَا رَاضِيَةٌ. Allah says, faces on that day will be beautiful. Because of the effort they made, they will be pleased. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Allah says, by the night as it covers and by the day as it comes in glory and by the creation of the male and the female, indeed your sa'i, indeed your efforts are diverse. There are some kinds of people, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for the one, what does he do? His first quality Allah describes him by, what does he do? أَعْطَى, he gives. He spends, fi sabilillah, he gives, his first description. Then taqwa, he has taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he believes correctly and Allah paves the way for ease for him. And as for the one, وَمَا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. He's a miser. He keeps his wealth to himself because he thinks, if I lose my money, I lose myself. Doesn't realize, of course, that his prophet said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, مَا نَقَصَتْ صَدَقَةٍ مِّن مَالٍ, that charity does not decrease your wealth, if only you knew. I didn't know, in fact, my dear brothers, that hug supporting 100 families. And when I thought of the number, I thought, subhanAllah, 100 families. What about the example of that one person? What's his name? Ali bin Hussein, radiallahu anhu, rahmatullah alayh. It's not Hussein bin Ali. It's not Hussein, the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib. It's Ali bin Hussein. Ali, the son of Hussein. What's his example? كان الناس بالمدينة يعيشون ولا يدرون من أين يعيشون ومن يعطيهم. The people of Medina used to live, and they didn't know how they were living and who was providing for them physically, tangibly. فلما مات علي بن حسين فقدوا ذلك فعرفوا أنه هو الذي كان يأتيهم في الليل بما يأتيهم به. And when Ali bin Hussein died, they realized it was him who was bringing sacks of grain, sacks of wheat to everyone's homes in the night time. When he died, they saw on his shoulders, on his backs, marks. And they said about him, كان يعول مئة أهل بيت بالمدن. He used to feed 100 families. He used to feed 100 families in the night time by going by himself on his excursions with sacks on his back, feeding these people. This is an example of one from the Ahlul Bayt, one from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What an example for us, and what a legacy someone like him leaves behind for us, that I can stand here today 1,400 years later and remind you and recount his fadail, his virtue for you. This is someone who fed 100 families, my dear brothers. وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. We will only have, my dear brothers, what we made effort for. What we made effort for. I was asked to speak about the fact that those who are tested with a hardship, prisoners or children or orphans, they of course have their own reward, and we shouldn't lose sight of that. It was so beautiful when the brother was singing. I wish he was singing and I wasn't speaking. But when he was singing, I thought, you know, you have this moment and you have this feeling in your heart, wallahi, this is a beautiful deen and beautiful ummah. There is nothing like this deen and nothing like this ummah. We are a people, there is no one like us, subhanAllah al-Azim. That is not a cause of pride or arrogance, but it's something that should move us towards action. The last song the brother sang was about love, wasn't it? It's about loving Allah. My dear brothers, think about this. Just think. How is it that Allah loves you? It's easy to say we love Allah. It's something else when Allah loves you. It's easy to say that I am this. It's something else when Allah says you're that. It's easy to say that I love Islam or I am a follower of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's something else that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would recognize you as his follower. We want to be of those who we know Allah is qareeb, Allah is close, but who is Allah close to is a different issue. If you want Allah to love you, the hadith says, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ. My servant does not draw close to me by anything except what I have made obligatory upon him. And increases to draw closer to me بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ, by the voluntary act of worship until I love that person. You want Allah to help you, you go the 5% extra distance, my dear brothers. If you want to be like the brother saying about those who Allah loves, then we must go the extra mile, we must take the extra step. The brother, the ayah that Murtaza quoted was, وَمَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي السَّقَرِ. What was your maslak? It's not, why are you in hell? It's saying, what was your maslak? What was the road that you took, the steps that you took, that landed you in the hellfire? What was the path that you trodden on, that landed you in the hellfire? قَالُوا, and they say, لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ وَلَمْ نَكُمْ نَطْئِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. We were not of those who used to pray, and nor were we of those who used to feed the poor. Right? That's a maslak, that's a path that they've taken. Unlike the path of Hajar alayhi salam, and unlike the path of others like her, who spent in Allah's cause, who made effort for His sake. And that's what we must do in this time, my dear brothers. What happens to a people Allah tests? And it's not just about being an orphan. Even though, look at this, my dear brothers, the verse, the ayah and the surah in the Quran is Surah Duha. But before Allah begins, Allah takes two oaths. وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى. Now the Mufassirin say about these ayatain that وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى are two calm periods. The duha is the bright early morning. And the layl إِذَا سَجَى is the night when it's still. It's not a gloomy night. It's not like a forsaken night. It's in fact a still night. And one of the commentators say, this is like the orphan. This is like the life of an orphan. His life is just still. He's waiting for who? For daddy's return. His life is still. His life is a life of contemplation. His life is a life of reflection. He's thinking, what on earth happened to me? Unlike what happened to other people. How come they have this but I don't have that? وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا دَعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. Your Lord has not forsaken you. And nor does He scorn you. And Allah says, indeed, the akhir, the last part of your life is better than the ula, better than the first part. And Allah says, أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ. Did your Lord not find you? ضَالًا فَهَدَى. You were lost in the way and Allah guided you. You were yateeman فَآوَى. You were an orphan and Allah gave you shelter. You were عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. You were poor and Allah enriched you. So what's the resolution then? Allah is reminding us, my dear brothers, and reminding Him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you were this before Allah made you that. You were this before Allah made you that. So now that you're in a good situation, what should you do? فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرَ. As for the one who is an orphan, never repel him. Never repel the orphan. وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. And as for the one who asks you, do not be a nahar, and do not be a river unto the one who asks you. What does a river do? A river pushes out, pushes away. Allah says, you had it so easy, you had it so good because Allah gave you. Now don't turn away. Be shakir, be shakur, be grateful to Allah by now giving and spending in Allah's cause. That's what a believer does. The one who is tested by Allah, what does Allah do? مَنْ يُرِدْ لَهُ بِخَيْرٍ يُصِبْ مِنْهُ. In one hadith, whoever Allah desires good for someone, He tests him. إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا ابْتَلَاهُمْ. If Allah loves a people, He tests them. In one hadith, by Imam Tabarani, إِنَّ الرَّجُلْ لَيْكُنْ لَهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْمَنْزِلَةِ فَلَا يَبْلُغُهَا بِعَمَلٍ حَتَّى فَمَا يَزَالُ يَبْتَلِيهِ بِمَا يَكْرَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests a person. Inna rajul, indeed a man, he has a certain manzil, he has a position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he cannot reach by way of his actions. So Allah gives him tests so that he will reach that position. His actions can't take him to that position, so Allah will test him in his body, in his wealth, in his family, in his children, so that he can reach to that position. It's a blessing in disguise, my dear brothers. It's a blessing in disguise. This is why Allah says, وَذِكْرَ لِلْعَبِدِينَ, and it's a reminder for those who worship. My dear brothers, we are approaching the month of competition. The month in which Allah sees who can outdo who. Who can be the best of the best? And I'll end with one narration, because I know the brother's standing, so that's like my warning sign. With one narration, isn't it? It's true, isn't it? Okay. With one narration. You know, when he had died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Abu Bakr became Khalifa, and then he died, radiallahu anhu, and Umar became Khalifa, radiallahu anhu, there was an entourage of Sahaba who went to see Umar ibn Khattab. Amongst them were the first comers, the early people, the slaves, the weak, like Bilal radiallahu anhu, and those people, the as-sabiqun al-awwalun min al-muhajirin wal-ansar, the first of the first. And amongst them were the latecomers like Abu Sufyan and others amongst them. They were latecomers, but they all came together as a group of Sahaba radiallahu anhum jami'an. They all came. They knocked on the door of Sayyidina Umar, and he opened the door. And when he saw each people, his eyes became fixed on the eyes of Bilal radiallahu anhu, and he saw him, and he ushered him and his group in. The group of the weak ones, the group of the first comers, the first of the first, he brought those Sahaba in, come inside. And when Abu Sufyan and his entourage, who were the noble men of Quraysh, saw that, they said, "Oh Umar, you have disrespected us. You've disrespected us because we thought, you know, you would give us some position, and we are men of Quraysh and leaders of Quraysh and this and that." And so one of the leaders from that group, he said these words. He said, "Listen, in kuntum ghidaban fa'aghdibu ala anfusikum, da'il qawm wa da'itum fa'asra'u wa abta'tum." If you are angry, then be angry only with yourself. They were called to Islam like you were called to Islam, and they were quick in responding and you were slow in responding. The day that we're in stands as a hujjah for us, or against, as a proof for us or against us. We heard the reminder, we saw the video, we heard the brother speak. It's a proof for us or it's a proof against us. إِنَّمَ النَّاسِ مُبْتَرًا وَمُعَافًا فَرْحَمُوا أَهْلَ الْبَلَاءُ أُحْمَدُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعَافِيَةِ. Like in the Muslim Imam Malik, Isa alayhi salam says that إِنَّمَ النَّاسِ, people are either those who have ibtila, either those who are tested, or they are those who have afia. They're just preserved. They're fine. The bodies are fine. The mind is wandering wherever it goes because it's comfortable. Either you're one who is tested by Allah or you're someone who is preserved by Allah. So what do you do then? فَرْحَمُوا أَهْلَ الْبَلَاءِ. Have mercy with the people of suffering and tribulation and hardship. And thank and praise Allah for your afiyah. Thank and praise Allah for your afiyah. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. And one of the Mufassirin and maybe others have said, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. As for the ni'mah Allah has given you, فَحَدِّثْ, and speak about it. It includes wealth. Includes the ni'mah of wealth. Allah has given you it, spend it. Let people see that you're spending it in Allah's cause. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward the brothers of hugs and to reward everyone, you know, who will contribute. And of course we already have, but may we contribute more and give in Allah's cause. And may Allah give us strength and istiqamah in these times and make our work the work of the brothers and our collective work as an ummah a productive work. And may we be of those who hold fast to this religion in these testing times. May we not be of those who sell out, who lose our deen along the way. May we be of those who stick together strong as an ummah and sincere towards him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah send peace and blessings upon his prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon his companions and family. Walhamdulillah rabbil alamin.